look at the comparison with Joe Biden and say whatever we think of him, he's not going to be a Democrat subject, especially these days, to the pressure of the left. Look, I bought that argument in 2016.
No, he's going to be subject to the pressure of Vladimir Putin and Xi Jinping. He's a person willing to sell out the interests of the American people for his own re-election. What could be worse in Hillary Clinton or Joe Biden's philosophy than betraying your country to a hostile foreign leader?
Trust me, I understand that point.
Will you answer that question?
Yeah, I'm trying to.
Okay, I'm sorry. My apologies. Go ahead.
What I thought in 2016 was we at least have to try it out. And so I voted for Trump. Having experienced 17 months of working with him, I can't in good conscience do that again. And that's why I'm not going to vote for him, and I'm not going to vote for Biden.
I guess what's exasperating is there is absolutely nothing that Donald Trump has done that is surprising to me. My rule is everything you think about Donald Trump is probably true because he's not deep enough to get your socks wet in. He's incredibly readable. That's why when he ran casinos, the house lost. There's nothing to learn about him. That's why he's essentially a boring person. How did you not know beforehand that he was just callow?
Because I couldn't believe it was that bad. And I know other people say they saw it from the beginning.
But you're an international negotiator. How could you be naive? You've dealt with the worst people in the world.
You've really insulted me now by calling me naive. I thought it was possible to work with somebody. I thought surely they would want to learn about the complexities of arms control negotiations and that sort of thing. And as I detail in the book, that turned out not to be true.
Ambassador, we have to take a quick break, but stick around.